Hello and welcome everyone. This is Veronika Kozova, Cisco NetSec Technical Marketing Engineer. And in today's video demonstration, we are going to showcase you how to migrate EPS remediation module to ANC remediation module. As part of the today agenda, we are going to talk about valid remediation module use case. Then we are going to discuss what's new in regards to the connection between FNC and ICE. Then we are going to talk about the benefits of PXGrid 2.0 protocol. And then we are going to showcase you the steps that are required in order to migrate EPS to ANC. And as a last step, we are going to showcase you ANC remediation module in action. So let's have a look how this all is done. All right, as part of the migration from EPS to ANC, remediation, we need to reconfigure following elements in the network: Cisco ICE and Cisco FMC. And once we reconfigure those two components, then we can validate that the remediation action continues working as it used to with EPS. Our workflow for verification would be as follows. The client would try to connect to some malware testing website and download the testing malware file, which will be blocked on the FTD. That will trigger malware event from NG firewall to the FMC. And FMC has configured correlation rule, which says that when some suspicious activity, for example, malware event occurs, quarantine this host and assign following ANC policy, for example, with quarantine action. So FNC will do it in automatic programmatic fashion. It will connect or talk to the ICE, and it will provide the IP address of the source host that generated the suspicious activity. And then ICE will do the lookup of IP address to MAC address. So basically it will try to find an endpoint information through the session lookup. Once it finds the endpoint, it will assign the required ANC policy. And that ANC policy will be assigned to the host by ICE connecting to NAD switch through the change of authorization. And it will basically instruct to disconnect the client. When the client reconnects, the switch will talk again with the ICE. And during the authentication and authorization process, well, the client will get assigned, let's say, another SGT tag that should help quarantine access in the network. So basically this tag will be assigned to the client, and when the client continues talking on the network and reaches FTD, which has access control policy rule that says when the users that are coming from the quarantine HTTP tag have access denied to any part of the network, so the traffic will be blocked. And with this, we will achieve the remediation use case. Obviously, then we can set up another trigger which will then clear the ANC policy for this user, so he can communicate to the network successfully. PXGrid is a communication protocol that we use for FMC and ICE integration. In order to obtain user identity information into the firepower, such as user to IP mappings, user to SGT mappings, SXP mappings, and endpoint profiles. In Firepower 6.7 release, we have upgraded this communication PXGrid protocol from PXGrid 1.0 to PXGrid 2.0. And due to this change, we need to migrate EPS to ANC remediation module, because EPS remediation module was leveraging PXGrid 1.0 protocol, and ANC remediation module is leveraging PXGrid 2.0 protocol. In order to confirm that FNC is integrated with ICE over PXGrid 2.0, We can perform following verification steps. On FMC, we navigate to System, Integration, Identity Sources, and here under Identity Services Engine, the tab, as you can see, it's already pre-configured because the system has been already integrated with ICE and it was using EPM remediation. When we click on the test, that will basically verify connectivity between ICE and FMC. And you see the communication is successful. If we do the drop down and see the additional box, we can find the confirmation that indeed FMC is talking to ICE over the PXGrid 2.0 and the TCP port 8910 is used for bound download. And also this connection is testing that the services on the ICE side are working fine. Now, if we swap to the ICE, we can navigate to administration, then PXGrid services. And you can notice in all under all clients that FMC connection is in offline state by using XMPP protocol. However, FMC starting from 6.7 release and ICE 2.7 and 3.0 are not leveraging XMPP protocol for the integration, but rather WebSockets. So that's why, in order to validate from the ICE perspective that FMC connection is up, we navigate to web clients and we locate the client name of FMC and its IP address. And we will notice that this status is on. And this is it. This is how we confirm basically that the communication over PXGrid 2.0 between FMC and ICE is working. So why we have migrated PXGrid 1.0 to PXGrid 2.0 protocol? The reasons are because the PXGrid 2.0 has a couple of advantages. So for example, it provides active HA support comparing to the PXGrid 1.0, which was delivering active-passive HA model. Then PXGrid 2.0 is also delivering us greater scale in number of clients that ICE can support. And also it's now providing a support to ANC remediation module, which is leveraging PXGrid 2.0 protocol instead of EPS that is using PXGrid 1.0. So those are the primary benefits of PXGrid 2.0 implementation in regards to FMC to ICE integration. All right. After we have validated successful communication between FMC and ICE over PXGrid 2.0, let's revisit the health warning that administrator sees on FMC. And as we can notice, the system has detected that EPS remediation is being used, which will not work with current PXGrid connection to ICE. Because as we said before, EPS remediation module is using PXGrid 1.0, but the current releases are leveraging PXGrid 2.0, and that's why we need to migrate EPS remediation to ANC remediation. And we are going to have a look how this is done. But first of all, let's navigate to ICE, Operations, Adaptive Network, Policy List. Let's make sure that we have configured the ANC policies. So as you can see, we have one ANC policy configured with the quarantine action. We can create manually multiple other ANC's policies with different type of actions, depending what we need. The quarantine action actually means that it will disconnect the client upon which it might reconnect. The shutdown will actually shut down the port where this spoofing device is connected. And so in this way, it will prevent the re-authentication. Port bounce is actually self-explanatory. And then we have re-authenticate option. In case you don't see the re-authentication option, please make sure that you are on ICE 2.6 patch 7 or ICE 2.7 patch 2 or ICE 3.0 or anything higher. Under endpoint assignment, we will see any endpoints that has associated ANC policy. And the associated policy could happen manually. Administrator can here put the MAC address or IP address and associate the configure ANC policy. But iSystem also allows to the assign ANC policy in automatic fashion in within the as part of the integration. So in this case, we are going to assign ANC policy in automatic fashion or programmable fashion from FMC. So for that, we need to go to policies, instances on FMC side. Here we will notice that we have configured EPS remediation instance. In order to migrate from EPS to ANC, we need to select the new module, which is ANC. We click add. All right, we provide the name, which is ANC remediation. We keep enabled logging. We hit create. And we can apply the remediation for either source or destination. In our case, we would like to quarantine this source that has generated suspicious activity. We provide again the name, so ANC remediation, and let's put also action, which is quarantine. And here in the dropdown for ANC policy, we should see all configured ANC policies that we have on the ICE. In this case, we have only one, but here the list dropdown will be higher in case we have multiple ANCs configured on ICE. Okay, so in this case, we are going to leverage the quarantine action. So we have selected ANC policy name quarantine AGP, and we create this remediation module. We save it. And now under policies correlation, we need to associate to the correlation policy the ANC module instead of EPS module. And this is done under responses. And you see here is the assigned response, which is EPS. So we are going to disassociate it, and we are going to replace with ANC remediation quarantine instance. And that's it. Upon this change, the system will leverage ANC instead of EPS, and every other aspect of this configuration remains the same as with EPS setup. So now we can go back to the instances, and we can safely remove the old EPS remediation module. Now we need to wait at some time in order for the health module to rerun in order it to disappear. And now, as you can see, after a certain amount of time, when the health alert will rerun, which is by default each 5 minutes, the health warning will disappear because now we have successfully migrated EPS to ANC remediation. All right, before we start testing whether the ANC remediation module works, let's revisit what are our trigger conditions. So on the FMC, as per the correlation ruleset, we are monitoring if the malware event occurs, and if it occurs, it will assign to the source host the ANC policy with the quarantine HGD name, which has assigned the quarantine action. And basically, FMC will instruct the ICE to quarantine that user and assign the ANC policy with quarantine HGD tag name. And in case that user, after the re-authentication, try to trigger the traffic on the network, or will try to access some resources on the network, the ICE will determine that this host has assigned quarantine HGT ANC policy, and for such user, it will change its security group tag. And this is important because if Such traffic generated from the client that has assigned ANSI policy with Quaranta SGK name, and that has assigned basically security group tag quarantine systems, such traffic, accordingly to access control policy firewall rule set, will be denied. So now we are ready to start validating the configuration with the real traffic. All right. Now we are going to trigger the ANSI remediation quarantine action. So we are logging to the console of the client that will generate the traffic, which passes through the FTD. So let's log into this machine using Active Directory credentials, and this machine is part of the Active Directory domain. And the user, upon a successful logon, it will generate the new live session. And as you can see, the client got assigned var user HGT tag. And currently there are no quarantine hosts, none of the endpoints in the network has associated ANSI policy. So this user should be able to access any resources from the internet, such as Google, as you can see. However, now we are going to trigger the quarantine action by accessing some testing malware files. So we are going to download from our server eker.com.zip file, which will be detected by the FTD as a malware. And as you can see, it indeed happened, and FTD successfully blocked access to this malware. This trigger on the background, the correlation rule on the FNC instructed ICE to assign this user the ANSI policy. And you see indeed it happened. The endpoint got assigned quarantine HGT ANSI policy with quarantine action. Okay, and at this point, the user should disconnect and reconnect back to the network, and it should get refreshed the security group tag. As you can see, it has quarantine systems. So now if you will try to access the internet-based resources such as google.com, as you can see, the page is loading for some time, and it will be eventually blocked based on our firewall rule that denied any type of traffic that is sourced from the HGT tag. And indeed, it happened that this user has no longer access to the internet resources because it has been quarantined. So from the FNC perspective, we can validate that the remediation was completed successfully. We can navigate to analysis correlation status, which is presented on this screen, and we see that our remediation instance has kicked in as part of our correlation demo policy, following correlation rule trigger, and the remediation between FMC and ICE has been successfully issued. And then when the user generated the traffic that reached FTD, the traffic flow has been denied from the user one because of the configured rule, because the traffic has been sourced from the quarantine source stack. And this concludes our verification section.
That's all for today's demonstration. Thank you very much for your attention. And don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you in the next one.